I like it when you do that. Twinsies! Twinsies!
Is it on?
Aye.
With my brother from another mother.
Good Lord. Good Lord, Bloodstep. Bloodstep.
Bloodstep. Dubstep. Bloodstep.
Dubstep. Little bit of dubstep. Boom. Strap. Dubstep. Boom.
Right. Bloodstock 2016.
Serious. Heavy metal.
My arms are aching, and that's the truth, because I went to see The King Is Blind at the Sophie stage earlier on, and this man here, Steve Tovey, had me punching my hand in the air and riffing so much. And he tried to get me in. He had a crazy bloody mosh pit going on. He tried to get me in, but because my dodgy knee, my mum wrote me a note.
You got the smallest violin going on from out here. He's like,
that was awesome.
Scared of the mosh pit, weren't you?
I was scared of the mosh pit.
I loved it, man. They were beating the shit out of each other.
He's got a small violin. Look.
Oh, nice.
The tiny violin just for me gets.
I am impressed, though, that you're mobile. Oh,
no. That was so superb. What a show.
Really, really enjoyed it. It's we always kind of, like, when we spoke last time, try and keep our expectations low, but we know when we played 2 years ago at Bloodstock, it went down well. So we kind of had a few tingles that it could be a good one, and people didn't disappoint us. They gave back what we were giving, which can't ask for more than that.
But what was really noticeable as well, because Rotting Christ obviously were playing at the same time.
Yes.
When Rotting Christ finished, you could see all the people wandering out, and then they heard the noise and saw the dust coming up from the pit, and all of a sudden there was another few hundred people wandering in, which was superb.
And the other bit there, I mean, speaking of that, I mean, clashing with a band like Rotting Christ, who've got a long heritage, we've done all right. You know, there's good turnout, even despite the fact they're on and people know the songs. Yeah. And that's been one of the most interesting things of the last few months, is people start shouting your lyrics back at you, which, like, first time it happens, it's a bit like, hey, wow, that's pretty cool. Then it's like, oh, shit, I've got to remember them now because they know them better than I do. And it was really good.
Is that the first time you've ever performed the track with the gentleman from Winterfileth live?
No, we were lucky enough that I've lost track now. When we toured with Winterfileth at the end of last year, Chris came up, even though the album wasn't out yet. He came up and did the vocals when we played with them. It was good to do it at a fest and get him up. He's got a fucking savage black metal voice, and
everyone loved it when he came up. Yeah. Everyone had the horns up and stuff. It was good. And you bounce off each other, don't you? So
yeah, and it's good. And the good bit about it is when I've done the vocals for that track, like when we played at Download, I don't know it as well as he does. So he was better at it than I. Mm-hmm. Don't tell him that, he's big-headed bastard as it is. But no, it was really good to have him up there. It's a good energy again. I think that was the whole thing for us about today, was we in the studio, we're about being like dark and twisted and getting the technique right, and you know, that sort of thing. Live, it's more about the fucking metal of it, of just like this full-on kind of like,
but you're such a front man though, so even when it went into the really nice tinkly bit in the track, and you were like, you even ruined it by going, right, everyone, and the rest of the band are bringing it down. And you just wanted everyone to get ready to whip it back up again. But that's what you need. You need front men to be out there and come on an audience.
And I think, I mean, there's a lot of talk around the state of modern British metal in various places. And I do think the front man is something that a lot of bands are missing in a way. I mean, I look back to, obviously, Bruce Dickinson being the guy that I grew up with.
Yeah.
But even in the more extreme metal side of it, someone like Danny from Cradle, you know, he's always been able to command an audience. And it's about learning from people like that, and learning from Bruce, as a massive fan, is the fact that, you know what, it may be a serious bit, but you can be a bit cheeky sometimes because people are often ready to kick off, but they always sometimes need to be invited to do it. It's almost like, you know, you say to them, right, this is the mosh pit. Oh, look, the mosh pit got bigger, that sort of thing. And it's, but I enjoy it. I love it. You know, it's, you can take yourself too seriously live, and we don't. We don't fuck around, but for us, you know, the whole point of doing a band, and we've mentioned many times our age and being later in life, is fucking enjoying it. Doing something creatively in the studio, but live about just
being
a metal band.
It's show business, not the rock, not the music proficiency business. And you're in a metal band, so you've got to fucking show it, haven't you?
There's too many bands that are a bit scared to be metal. You know, they're like, oh, it's cheesy, and oh, no, we can't possibly. We've got to be all serious and noodly. Fuck off.
No.
It's just fucking headbang, you know, play big riffs. And headbang. I think that live, that's what connects.
And that's what people want.
Yeah, exactly. I think, you know, for us as well today, mid-afternoon, people had a couple of beers, they're in the right frame of mind, and as we were talking about, the gentlemen who were in the pit ripped and beating the shit out of each
other. I know, they were. When you were telling me to go in there, I was like, no way I'm going in there. Like, they're smacking it. Ah!
It's brilliant. But, you know, I think, again, metal is something that, as you know, Preach to the Converted, but you can get out positive energy. You can get out, you know, you come out with this sort of like buzz because you're doing it the right way. You know, you're not kind of maiming people or trying to hurt them, but there's that physicalness of metal. You know,
and you get the endorphin rush from it as well, don't you? So
exactly,
you get to feel great. So.
Even if it's just headbanging, it's headbanging or moshing or whatever it is. And I think that it creates this kind of like two-way thing. So, you know, the best shows we've done, I Like Today or Like a Download, where the people give back what
we put in.
And that's just, you know, it's great feeling.
I can't lie.
Oh, mate.
You've got to be excited about that, haven't you?
Yeah.
I just interviewed David and Jason, and they're pretty excited about taking you out. And
no, it's good to know that a band that we respect is as interested in us going and play with them as we are playing with them. But we knew a few months before it was announced, and we're under strict instructions that, you know, obviously one of the worst stroke best kept secrets in extreme music. But, you know, I mean, one of our things was about not being the band that goes out and plays with everyone and not being the band that people get bored of seeing.
Yep.
And picking someone that we respect and want to ally ourselves with and be aligned to. And, you know, if you're talking about a British heavy metal band that has a creative, you know, legacy to, you know, they've got to be top of the list. And so, you know, I think with the stuff that's on Our Father being a dark, twisted, involved concept album, I think it's a really good mix.
Yeah,
and,
definitely.
You know, both bands are quite happy to smack you in the face with like brutal riffs, but both bands are quite happy to kind of branch things out and take it in different directions. So I think
it's quite circular as well, though, of course, because Paul Ryan was in Cradle of Filth. Cradle of Filth were a huge influence on Aka Kocka, and now Aka Kocka are taking the King's Mind out, who featured Paul Ryan and yourself, who in turn were, you said that Danny's quite an influence in your vocal
style. Yeah, and I think as well with Aka Kocka, you know, when we look at albums like Chorenson and Rape of Bastard Nazarene, they're an influence for us in with Our Father, to know that, you can have a kind of, this sort of riff, and then do something different with it.
Slow it down a bit. And
you can really vary things up. And they were, you know, definitely a part of that for us. So, it's just delighted. I think the places we're going to in England, so unfortunately we're not in Dublin. It costs too much to get to Dublin. The places that are in England that we're playing, I think are in for a treat. I think it's going to be a good lineup. You know, I think
Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, Matt.
Time,
thanks for having us.
And thank you for letting me see you at last.
I know, first time.
Third attempt.
I know.
At seeing you, and I finally have. And I'll see you at... on the tour as well.
So when Matt said in the last interview that he'd just seen us destroy Download, he hadn't.
No, I was lying.
But he did see this one.
Yeah. What was wrong with you?
Stop filling me off flies.
Get it out, son.
Mup says stop filling my flies.
Say ya.